What is going on, everyone? Today we're going to be doing a Sea of Thieves noob to noob guide. So what that means is I'm a noob, and this is for people who are also noobs, just like myself. And this is to answer some questions that I had that I couldn't find, because I guess the game is relatively new. So let's just get right on into it here. Loading on up. Be there, you can skip all that. So naturally you have two options, the galleon or the sloop. Right now we'll be doing the sloop because it's only going to be myself. So the sloop can be either 1 to 2 players, galleon can be 3 to 4. Go here, sail alone. Obviously I've already made my character. There's not a character creator as there is a character generator. So you'll have 5 options you can make. You can highlight one to say, okay, I like this one, but I want to see what else you have. Hit 3 generation button. That one will stay there, and you'll get plenty of extra or plenty of other options. And there is quite a extensive generation. I wish there was a character creation, because looking when you do the generation part of it, there is a ton of different options that you could really do. One of my friends who play, my crewmates here, he has, you know, a dead eye, you know, where it's all blind, and, a lot of different people have different body types, so the generation of it's pretty well done. I just wish there was a creation part of it. So as we load on in. Alright, we are loaded in. Usually it loads you inside of a tavern. But maybe this island is just that small. Alright. So, first things first, when you load in, you should be loading in a tavern, but apparently I'm just on a random island. You'll hit the left bumper, and this will give you all your basic tools. At first, you'll want to go ahead and eat a banana. It'll give you a small little tutorial to do so. You'll go ahead and select by pushing the right joystick, push it up. You'll select it. I don't have any, so it doesn't show it. Then you'll hit the right trigger to eat it. That will then allow you to hit Y, and you'll be able to switch between your weapons. There's 3 weapons. There's the shotgun, or 4 weapons. Shotgun. There is the sniper rifle, which I just had right here. There's a sword and a regular pistol. We can do random emotes by pushing down on the D-pad. And if you push up on the right joystick or in any direction, you'll see it highlight there. You can also say your basic text by pushing up on the D-pad. And same thing in any direction, X for more. Alright, now let's get to the ship, so we can actually get on what the quests refer to as voyages. So, here we go. Here's our little dinghy here. Here's our ship. go right over here. We have two different tables here on the small one. We have the voyage table, where you would vote to go on a voyage, which we'll show you how to get to. And then we have our map hit X, right trigger to zoom in, left trigger to zoom out. It really helps to zoom in to find, you know, some of these islands are really small, and you never know, depending on the voyage, you may need to locate those small items. So what we're gonna do is, I'm on Discovery Ridge. Let's see which way the wind is carrying us. So if we come out here and we look up, we can see that we are headed into the wind right now. So we want to go to our backs. We have Plunder Outpost. So we'll go ahead and sail to Plunder Outpost here. Right on, here we go, our armory. This is where we can switch between our guns. So we will put the pistol on and we will put the sword on. And now I have a sword and a pistol. If I run out of ammo, come back here, use the ammo chest. There's also ammo chests throughout the game. So depending on the island, there'll be ammo chests. We have barrels of supplies down here. We'll have bananas, which are good to eat. What they do is they regenerate your health. We have wooden planks, which we'll use if our ship takes damage and we will have to plug the holes. Right here we have the equipment chest, so we can change our equipment, which right now I only have the basic gear. And then we have the vanity chest, which we can switch our titles, which will be over our head, our hair, you know, all the cosmetic parts of the game. Here is our rum refill. Our rum cup, if we hit the left bumper, hit X, we get more. We get our, you know, our musical devices and our rum cup. It's already full, so we don't need to be drinking it right now. Lanterns. And up top, we're going to have our extra cannonballs. Now, one thing important about cannonballs is when you first jump on, you'll see that our cannons are not loaded. But when we load them, obviously one cannon per cannon, or cannonball per cannon, you can hold a maximum of 10 at a time. So if you happen to be in a cannon fight, make sure you run over to where your cannons are. Each ship is different. Load up on 10 cannons, and then when it comes time to start shooting, you'll have 10 on you versus shoot, run back, shoot, run back. Another thing, nice bit of advice here is the lanterns at night. If they're not on, I mean, they don't really give you that much visibility anyway. If they're not on, it's harder for enemy ships to see you. But with that being said, let's get moving here. So we know where our wind is. What we're going to do is we're going to let down the sail. Push X here and push down to let down the sail. We can go all full or we can go half mast, but right now we want to get there as fast as possible. We'll also need to angle the sail into the wind. There's one on each side, of course. But for right now, we're just going to get our heading. So, right, left up the anchor. And turn the wheel. You'll hear a click when you're... Bad example. So when this gold piece is up, is usually when it's all the way to the right or in center. You'll also hear a click when your rudder is fully straight, which will give you an idea right now. Right there. If you can hear that, that's the rudder saying. Our rudder is straight. So it's almost kind of like an autopilot. We got a big old island right there we don't want to hit. Now, being a one player, navigating can be a bit tricky. You have to make sure you're headed the right direction and all that goodness. Which what we're going to do is we are headed in the wrong direction. We need to head south, east from where we are. Yeah. We have our compass. this right here. Southeast. Now we're going to need to angle the sails. The wind is going to my left, so we'll angle it left. Once you hear it poof, there's the poop. Alright, now we are more or less full steam ahead. Double check our map. Give an island to our left, and then it'll be straight ahead. There's also the crow's nest there. You can climb up and get a better view of what's going on. But for now, we're just sailing straight ahead, right to the big island. Well, a bigger island. Grab our cannonballs. We're going to go ahead and load one in each. You can also shoot yourself out of the cannon, which sometimes makes closing the distance fun. We got a big island on our right. We're gonna go ahead and just tap it to the left here. In our tools, we have quite different ones depending on the quest that we'll be using. Obviously, we have a compass. We have a bucket, so when you are taking on water, you'll need to bail the water out, otherwise you will sink. So you'll bail out the water when you're taking damage. Lantern, left trigger to hold it up higher to get a better spread of view with the light. Right trigger to turn it off. Shovel, when you're digging up buried treasure. Spyglass, what we're looking for here. See, there's that little island that we're passing on the right. Do watch out, sometimes there's bad skeletons up on these posts, and they will shoot cannons at you. Be tricky, but we're looking good for right now. That should be the port. Straight ahead. There's even ships that are docked. Which, depending on the ship, can be quite difficult, because if they decide to attack me, I'm by myself, so I'm going to have to navigate and fire at the same time. Let's hope that doesn't happen. If you happen to fall off your ship, and you're only by yourself, what will happen is a sea mermaid will come up and get you, and it'll teleport you back to your ship. But what we'll do is we will simulate that and let you guys see what that looks like here. Almost there, as we can tell. We might be coming in way too hot here. Oh yeah. We're gonna crash. Come on. Ooh, that was close. Woo-hoo-hoo! Like a glove. If you guys come in too hot and you hit the anchor, you will damage the ship and take on water. So, come down here, make sure that didn't happen. Now, what can happen is they can raid my ship if it's sitting here. You can see a person right there. They can raid my ship. If we're sitting here, I can raid their ship. But for now, we're not going to do that quite yet. So, here we are. We're at a big port. They also steal my ship if they want to. Here we are. We're at a big port. We'll be friendly here. Wave. Hello. Alright. So we're at a port. So there's three different guilds or merchants that you can work with. Gold, Soul, and the Merchant Alliance. This gentleman here, and they're on every outpost. So when you pick up here, you don't have to come back here. But this gentleman here, he does the gold order. We have a little witch lady. Where is the witch lady? Witch lady right over here. We'll see the little flag. She does the kill missions. Sorry, the gold guy, he does the treasure hunt missions. She will do like the kill the skeleton missions.
I need spines. Which we snapping. Can
pick one up right now. Oh, look at this. A new lantern. The higher the rank that you get with them, the more. This is a new drink. This is a new lantern. The more stuff you'll unlock. Push A to pick it up. To quote unquote buy it. At the beginning, when you buy them, they will cost zero.
Wreck some ribs.
And you'll see, you have all kinds of shop merchants here.
Hiya.
Each one selling. All kinds of different things. New weapons, new clothes, hooks, peg legs, hats. All very expensive stuff. We'll go to the docks here. The other one's always on the dock.
Scared.
This is for the merchants. They usually do collecting kind of items. So you will be finding chickens, finding Think snakes, finding pigs. When you do pick up the mission, you'll come back here. And they will give you a coop, a chicken coop or whatever, and chicken coop or a pig trap, and you'll take those back to your ship. Another important thing is while we're at the docks, when we come, if we find these barrels here, we can find more cannonballs to take back to our ship. We can find more wooden planks to take back to our ship. This lady here, she sells.
Sure.
Customization stuff for your ships. That's cool. Different masts and all that kind of stuff. Some of them are level based.
Come back for a chat anytime.
Some items you can only hold 5 of. The cannonball you can hold 10. We're gonna do a piratey thing here. We're gonna board their ship. Lift up their anchor. We're gonna let it go. And then while we're on here, we're gonna take all their stuff. And then what I'm gonna do is load myself up in the cannon. And then swim back to my ship. That's quite the mean thing to do, but hey, it is a pirate game after all. You do have to be careful swimming, because there are sharks, and they will kill you. And if you die, you go to Davy Jones Locker, which is more or less just a respawn area. Now the voyages definitely seem to be located from where you pick them up. They seem to be somewhat closer, but the higher level ones will make you travel the world. So, alright, back up on my ship. We're gonna go to the voyage table. Propose a voyage. Let's see here. I wasn't really paying attention to which one I grabbed. So we'll do this one. A to propose it, X to vote on it. And now we hit the right bumper. You'll see here, we have one map. Sometimes you'll have multiple, depending on the voyage. Push up on the right joystick, and then right trigger to read it. It tells you here, Paradise Springs. He's rumored to be on Paradise Spring. So what we're gonna do, come over here, and we see Paradise Spring is right there. Because we've been zoomed in. If we were zoomed out, we wouldn't be able to tell what the names are. Right trigger to zoom in, Paradise Spring. I like to hit the A on it, so I highlight it. We know, because our little legend at the bottom right of the compass, we know that's northeast from here, or right to our backside. Anchor up. Sail down. Oh, better turn the wheel. We're gonna wreck. Oh, yeah. That's gonna be a disaster. So, planks. Right trigger on the hull. Down here quick enough, but we are sailing without anybody driving here, so back on here, straighten her out. The wind is in our favor for the most part. We know we're headed northeast. Right. Sailing into the wind. That's probably Paradise Island right there, that itty bitty island. We can also see an enemy ship straight ahead, it looks like. You can see their lanterns. Douse my lantern. Grab my binocular here and check it out. Yep, enemy ship. So that's why you don't want to have your lanterns on at night. Unless you're asking for trouble. We are sailing into the wind, so not a whole lot we can really do. But just snail it over there. Make sure our heading's right. And our heading is right. Make sure we didn't take on any water. And we took on a little bit of water. Go ahead and scoop that up. Looking better. Now you have to throw this out into the ocean. Otherwise, you'll right back on your ship and it will just fill right back up. Ah! Third person view would be nice. There's our where we're headed here. I'm gonna put this up halfway to slow it down this time. Try to make our approach. You want to try to get as close as you can without getting too close, where you're gonna, beat your ship. Be about good. Hit that anchor. Remember, it does take a little bit of load for that to happen. We do have a cannonball. You can see some skeletons straight ahead, it looks like. Oh yeah. Time to go fight. they coming? Switch the gun. Oh. Well, not exactly how I wanted to show you guys Davy Jones' locker, but here's Davy Jones' locker. Now, this is where you're going to go to get back to your ship, but it gives you like a little loading time, so you have to wait for the door to open. And you'll see other people who died went to Davy Jones' locker here. So. And there is no Will Turner. Go. Usually it's easier with the crew. Surprisingly, sharpshooters here. So. Eat a banana. Get the health up. This is gonna be bad. Holy mackerel. You'll find more supplies here. Usually all over the ships you'll find supplies. Gosh, they got me again. Oh my goodness. Higher level missions definitely a lot harder. With the sword, if you hold down the right trigger, you'll do a lunge, and that will do more damage, but it's slower. And if you miss, you're tired. So, because I've died, I get more ammo. Get them on their spawn, they're a lot easier to manage. Oh boy. They too will eat bananas, so be careful. Speaking of bananas, you can hear a pig running around here, you've probably already seen it. So if this was a capture pig mission, you would come to any island. There's a pig there. Same thing with all the the snakes. The snakes and the chickens. Trigger is to block with your sword. Music has changed, which means it's go time. There's the captain. We're probably gonna die here. We're gonna ignore the captain for now. Kill his crewmate. Now it's your turn. Come on. There we go. Pick up the skull. Oh. Drop the skull. Eat a banana. Somewhere. There he is. I'm trying to. Got no more ammo. Trying to ruin my day. There's more bananas there. Eat another banana. And now I'll swim back to the ship. We're gonna go ahead and put this in our ship here. You can put it anywhere. I just put it down right here in the little captain's quarter. And now we have more we can do, but we're gonna go ahead and turn that one in here southwest from our location, or to the right. I know when we came in here we were cranking hard, so. And we'll be going with the wind this time, back to the port. Here we go, we should start drifting off to the right. Full sails. Let's get moving. Southwest is where we're headed. And whence we came. Alright. Felt the click. Angle the sails. Check our map. It's going to be a little bit on our right. Yeah, we were not very far. This is not a very big mission here. It only took so long to get there because we had the disaster of beaching the boat. Side of the island, so. are back at the docks. Come down here. Grab our treasure. See, I didn't do the world's greatest job, but I did an okay job parking there. Now one thing's important. When I'm here, and I'm running back this treasure, the other players can kill me and take it and pick it up and turn it in, or if I did a gigantic where I turned in three or four, or I completed three or four different voyages with maybe a big crew, and we're running back and forth, they can come in and they can take all my stuff. Right here. Exit, turn it in. See, we got 1,100 gold. This would be a level 3 mission. I've already done the introductory and the first and second. So if you come here, talk to her, you'll see at the top. Now I'm almost level 15 with them. So this would be a over level 10 mission for them.
Wreck some ribs.
And all right, guys, that's it. That's my noob to noob mission. If you have any questions, leave it down below. Remember to like and subscribe. And my gamer tag for the Xbox One is big_chalk_nasty. If you guys want to set sail with me, go ahead and just add me. And next time we'll go look for some Skull Islands. All right, see you later.